The express run to the South African Cape was one of the most important liner routes in the country and was inexorably linked to the fortunes of the port of Southampton. As one of the big Union Castle liners set off for the Cape and beyond every Thursday at 4, carrying passengers as well as cargo, including the all-important Royal Mail, it was a byword in travel. These mail ships included the Arundel Castle, Carnarvon Castle, Winchester Castle, Athlone Castle, Stirling Castle, as well as Edinburgh Castle and Pretoria Castle. The last great ships built for Union Castle in 1959 were Pendennis Castle, Windsor Castle and Transvaal Castle. The Union Castle line had its root in the amalgamation of two shipping lines. The Union Line was founded in 1853 as the Southampton Steam Shipping Company to transport coal from South Wales to meet the growing demand in Southampton. It was renamed the Union Steam Coal Company and then the Union Steamship Company. Orders were placed for 5 ships: Union, Briton, Saxon, Norman, and the Dane. The first steamship, the 336-ton Union, loaded coal in Cardiff in June 1854, but the outbreak of the Crimean War frustrated plans, and after the war the Union Steamship Company began chartering out its ships. In the summer of 1857, the Admiralty invited tenders for a new mail run to South Africa, and as the Union line, it was accepted. The Royal Mail contract was for 5 years with an annual subsidy of £33,000. The Cape Town Mail Service was inaugurated in 1857 with the 530-ton steamship Dane carrying the Royal Mail and 6 passengers under the command of Captain Strutt. There was little time to advertise and the revenue from the first voyage was £102, but the venture proved to be a success and the Dane was soon joined by the 613-ton Phoebe and the 739-ton Athens. By this time, Donald Curry from Greenock, a former employee of Cunard, had built up another shipping company, the Castle Packet Company, with 4 1,200-ton sailing ships with castle names, which traded around the Cape on the Liverpool-Calcutta run. This trade was threatened by the opening of the Suez Canal in 1869, and the line started to run to South Africa instead, later becoming the Castle Mail Packet Company. In 1872, the Cape Colony gained responsible government, and its first Prime Minister ordered a renegotiation of the country's mail services. In 1876, keen to avoid either of the two main companies gaining a monopoly on the country's shipping, he awarded the South African mail contract jointly to both the Castle Mail Packet Company and the Union Line. The contract included a condition that the two companies would not amalgamate, as well as other clauses to promote competition, such as alternating services and speed premiums. This competition led to the shipping services running at unprecedented speed and efficiency. The contract eventually expired, and the period of intense competition was to give way to cooperation, including transporting troops and military equipment during the Boer War. Finally, on the 8th of March 1900, the Union Line and Castle Shipping Line merged, creating the Union Castle Mail Steamship Company Limited, with Castle Shipping Line taking over the fleet. Union Castle named most of their ships with the suffix Castle. The names of several inherited from the Union Line were changed to this scheme. For example, Galician became Glenart Castle, but others such as Galica retained their original name. They were well known for their lavender-hulled liners and red funnels topped in black, running on a rigid timetable between Southampton and Cape Town. Every Thursday at 4, a Union Castle Royal Mail ship would leave Southampton bound for Cape Town, and at the same time a Union Castle Royal Mail ship would leave Cape Town bound for Southampton. The combined line was bought by Royal Mail Line in 1911, but continued to operate as Union Castle. Many of the line's vessels were requisitioned for service as troop ships or hospital ships in the First World War, and 8 were sunk by mines or German U-boats. The Royal Mail Line ran into financial difficulties in the 1930s, culminating in the prosecution of its director, and Union Castle once again became an independent company. Many vessels were again requisitioned in the Second World War. 3, Dunnottar Castle, Carnarvon Castle, Dunvegan Castle became armed merchant cruisers. Pretoria Castle was also first requisitioned as an armed merchant cruiser, but later served as an escort aircraft carrier. The company took over the King Line in 1949 and merged with Bullard King and Clan Line in 1956 to form British and Commonwealth Shipping. It merged with South African Marine Corporation in 1973 to create International Liner Services. In the 1950s and 60s, the line operated a fleet of 15 ships, 8 on the principal weekly mail run from Southampton to Cape Town. Each ship could carry an average of 200 first-class passengers and 450 in tourist class. 6 of the remaining ships operated the monthly Round Africa service, sailing both clockwise and anti-clockwise round the continent. The remaining ship operated a service carrying up to 750 tourist-class passengers to Beira via the West Coast route every 3 months. In 1965, the fleet of 7 mail ships necessary for the 11-day weekly service was completed with the construction of fast cargo liners, the Good Hope Castle and the Southampton Castle. These vessels had accommodation for 12 first-class passengers, mainly for people wishing to travel to St. Helena and the Ascension Islands. But technological progress and the invention of the jet engine meant mail could be delivered around the world far quicker than by sea and enabled the mass transportation of people by air. The days of the passenger liner and the regular mail services by sea were numbered, and in 1977 the Southampton Castle made the last Cape mail run from Southampton to Cape Town. However, the last ship to fly the mail pennant for the Union Castle Mail Steamship Company was the Kenpurini Castle. She carried the mail on a voyage from Southampton to Durban, calling at the Ascension Islands, St. Helena, Cape Town, Port Elizabeth, and East London. Also in 1977, on the 19th of September, the Windsor Castle returned to Southampton at the conclusion of her last mail run, 120 years and 4 days after the Danes set sail on the first epic voyage. The Union Castle mail ships would no longer depart from Southampton meticulously at 4 o'clock on a Thursday afternoon, a sailing which was only delayed once when the vessel waited 1 hour for Sir Winston Churchill to board. During the 1980s, a new breed of cargo carrier, the container ship, was introduced, which made the operation of small cargo vessels uncompetitive, and as a result, the British and Commonwealth Shipping Group abandoned its shipping operations and the Union Castle Mail Steamship Company ceased to operate. The last surviving Union Castle Line ships were scrapped in the early 21st century, the former Kenya Castle in 2001, the Transvaal Castle in 2003, the Dunnottar Castle in 2004, and finally the Windsor Castle in 2005.